Hello guys, my name is Manjot Singh from Lens Fashion Photography. In my last video on the new features of Photoshop 2020, you watched the new improved transform tools. In this video, you will watch the new improved wrap tool and split wrap. With enhancements made to the wrap tool, you get more control over creative wrapping in Photoshop. Simply add control points anywhere or divide your image with a customizable grid, then transform by individual nodes or a larger selection. With the wrap tool, you can now choose a new preset, grid size option 3x3, 4x4 or 5x5. Create your own custom size grids, add your own grid lines and anchor points, delete grid lines, select the drag multiple anchor points, undo individual steps of editing a wrap. To try it out, go to edit menu, choose transform and then wrap. Select a layer or an area in the image you want to wrap. After making a selection, go to edit menu, choose transform and then wrap, or press Ctrl plus T in Windows or Command plus T in Mac, then click the switch between free transform and wrap modes button in the option bar. To wrap your selection using a wrap preset, choose a wrap style from the wrap pop-up menu in the option bar. To create a custom wrap mesh, choose a grid size from the grid pop-up menu in the option bar. Select a default grid size 3x3, 4x4 or 5x5, or select custom and then specify the numbers of columns and row in the custom grid size dialog. To add more control grid lines to wrap mesh, choose an option to split the wrap. Go to in the option bar, click any of the split button, go to edit menu, then choose transform, then go for the split wrap horizontally, split wrap vertical or split wrap crosswire. Move the pointer within the mesh area and click where you place additional control grid lines. As you move the pointer over the wrap mesh, you will see the split lines tag the pointer when you click additional control points are added to the wrap mesh. To manipulate the shape, drag the control points, a segment of the bounding box or mesh, or an area within the mesh. When adjusting a curve, use the control points handles. This is similar to adjusting the handles in the curved segment of a vector graphics. Click on the grid lines to activate control points for editing the wrap. Click an anchor point at the intersection of the grid lines. Lets you edit the control points surrounding the anchor. Drag the control points to wrap the image. To select multiple points, shift plus click on anchor point, or click and drag the pointer over the points while holding down the shift key. A rectangular appears around the selected point if two or more points are selected. To deselect multiple points, shift plus click on the active anchor points, or click and drag the pointer over the active points while holding down the shift key. The rectangle surrounding the selected points automatically resize as points are selected or deselected. To delete a selected grid lines, control points along the lines are visible. Press delete or choose edit plus transform or remove wrap split. To delete both the horizontal and vertical grid lines passing through an anchor point, click the anchor point, then press delete or choose edit, then transform, then remove wrap split. Now I can show you how can we use new wrap tool. You can see I am a wrapping tattoo on the model body, placing the tiger tattoo on the woman's shoulder. Press Ctrl plus T in window or Command plus T in Mac to activate the transform tool and placing on the right place. Then open the menu with the right click of the mouse and select the wrap. Select default grid size 3x3, 4x4 or 5x5 according to the requirement. Clicking on the grid line to activate control points for editing the wrap. Click on an anchor point at the intersection of the grid lines. Lets you edit the control points surrounding that anchor. Drag the control points to wrap the image. You can see how the tattoo is wrapping around the shoulder by dragging control points. You can also use split wrap to adjust the small part of the object as I am doing here. By opening a right menu, select the split vertical and wrapping the tattoo with more control on the points. You can also use 4x4 or 5x5 mesh to get more control on the points. As I am doing here, after placing the object, click enter or click on the above tick. Just moving on the right place again, Little adjusting more by activating transform tool to look more realistic, I created a mask here using D key to activate foreground color to black. If it is in a white, use X key to select white to black. I am reducing the brush opacity 100 to 37%, painting the area to those are not in the light and I don't want into highlighted. After that, I am applying blur filter to look more realistic. Go to filter menu and then select Gaussian blur. Click OK. After little adjustment, I am finishing the transformation. Now in the same way, I am applying another image by using wrap tool. Unhide the layer of the new image that was already copied here. Placing the image, press Ctrl plus T in Windows and Command plus T in Mac to activate the transform tool and placing on the right place. Opening a menu by mouse right click and using skew option to place on the right place. If you want to know about all features of transform tool, watch my video on transform tools. I inserted a card above and also added a link in comment section. After that, opening a menu again by mouse right click and using wrap option to place on right place. Now you can watch how I am doing it as I did in Tiger Tattoo. In this example, I placed roughly. Take your time for better result. Now that's all for the today. I will come again with the new features of Photoshop CC 2020. Thanks for watching.